strike coming up next. It's a UFC lightweight division bout.
Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. Back to his feet. Ooh, that uppercut landed for him. Just misses there with the left.
Look at the whip action that comes before that kick. Shots up.
Martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling is really the entertainment.
Working off of his back here, looks like he may try to hip escape. Poirier's back in full mount.
Let's go! Get him off!
All right, half-guard form here, and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has submission options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to his ground and pound. Build a base, posture up, throw big strikes, get back in position, posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down with a really secure position in half guard.
Changes his stance. You'll see a lot of this from this fighter.
Look at the turnover in that kick.
Once again, making good use of his size as he lands the knee. Man, he's timed his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop him, John. Stop him. His double leg shot.
Oh, amplitude slam through there.
And very close. Like that might be the difference.
All right, now we take a look back at some of the action in that previous round, DC. A lot to like on both sides here.
I mean, both were intent on going forward. And what happens when nobody wants to take a step back? They meet in the middle. That's exactly what they did, and they both found success over the course of that round.
Deep breath in your cup. This next round, you really want to focus on ground control. You have to set up your takedown. I want you to maintain a dominant lead.
Okay, you ready? Round two. Ready?
All right, round two. Oh, he's got the knee on the belly. Could be trouble defensively. Landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to the goal. He throws his jab. He He may throw the right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down with the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's got to be confident that it's going to land, and he's got to really throw his whole entire body into those strikes.
Great upper body movement defensively, slips another strike there. As offensively, he hasn't been a world beater, but defensively, he's been something.
And that has to cause frustration for the opponent. Not being able to hit a guy that you want to really put away. But that's a testament to the head and the activity and the awareness of this fighter.
Oh, man, this guy kicks like a mule.
So hard. He kicks so hard every time you see him drive his shin into his opponent.
I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Whiffs on that offer. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. You got to figure out a way to get back to your feet. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu.
Poirier's going for a choke. So he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Gets up again here, but hurting. Muay Thai plump.
Look at those weapons. Look at how he uses his knees to the body.
Well, we know knees to be some of the most destructive strikes in MMA, and he's got that weapons game going.
He has got the knees going short of a bunch.
So there's the end of the round, and the tide has officially turned. A huge head strike to stun his opponent. We'll see which corner can adjust here moving forward.
I mean, they've got to be celebrating. They've got to be happy. Everything's working. But the other side has to be concerned. They have to figure something out, make some sort of adjustment to try to change the tide of this fight.
You're losing this fight. Have faith in your striking. This guy can't strike with you.
All right, so here we go. Third and final round.
Ooh, what a punch.
Oh, big left.
Oh, nice. He's taking off right now. Starts to put his feet on your hips, you gotta move them off.
Poirier's got a pretty deep bruise now, starting to appear on the right side of his body. His opponent has done a lot of work in that region tonight. Nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
To be when you're looking for a rest or a stool, his stamina has been a huge issue.
It's abandoned him, but he did it. He tried. He fought as hard as he could for as long as he could. Now it's about survival.
Poirier gets the tie clinch here. Well, he has really started to apply a lot of pressure.
That was
equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the victory by TKO. Huge result inside the Octagon tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliata's called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 55 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by TKO!
The celebration is on over there in the corner, and nothing subdued about it. They put a lot of time into this training camp and into this performance, and certainly their athlete delivered.
It was a result that they desired. They said, I don't care how this match ends, as long as I'm not standing there waiting on the judges. He got his opponent hurt, and he found the follow-up shots that allowed him to get the TKO. We'll be right back.